So I'm joined here today by Lloyd Russell-Moyle, who is the Labour MP for Brighton Kemptown, our local MP. Welcome to today's news again. Lloyd, what happened yesterday? Because everyone's scratching their head this morning. So,
Well, what has happened is the government have gone to the Queen and asked her to sign a prorogation order, which means that Parliament will be suspended for a number of weeks whilst a new Parliament is got together, a new Queen's speech is written, and the Queen will come and present that Queen's speech. What that does do is it does mean that any bills that are in play, bills around victims' rights, bills around court reform, all of they will be scrapped. Anything that is not completed by prorogation is scrapped and abolished. And it will also mean that Parliament is not sitting for some of the key weeks ahead of Brexit. And some people think, I think, that this has been used as a tactic to stop Parliament scrutinising the actions of the government and potentially to allow us to crash out of the European Union without a say by the people's representatives. This is extremely worrying because it looks like the first stages of overriding Parliament. And if that is the case, it would be a breach of the constitutional order of this country that Parliament holds the executive to account and not the other way around. And of course, the last time Parliament, against its will in such a way as we have now, was disbanded by the King, it led to a civil war. Now, I'm not suggesting that we're on a civil war footing, but I think that there are some areas here where we are getting very close to the bone, and it is very worrying. It can still be rolled back.
Yes.
And there is still a week and a bit that we will sit next week and we will pass legislation to try and stop some of the worst excesses here. Most prorogations in the past have been about 2 or 3 days, so there is no requirement for it to be this long. It is therefore a political act to be this long and prevent Parliament sitting.
So it was unexpected, this, wasn't it? Do you think they've kind of played Parliament in a way?
Matthew Hancock, the Health Secretary, said it would be a breach of everything our soldiers fought for in the World War to shut down Parliament in such a way. Mm. You know, Parliament was not shut down in the Second World War in this way, and you could argue if that kind of national emergency didn't require Parliament to be shut down in this way, what does this?
So, what can be done in the short term? You've got just a week and a bit Parliament. And there is a legal challenge. Gina Miller has got one legal challenge. There's the legal challenge up in Scotland as well, hasn't it?
So there are legal challenges that have been lodged in Northern Ireland, in Scotland, and in England and Wales. England and Wales is one political system. And I am one of the joint people in Joanna Cherry's case in Scotland. We had lodged that already, actually, a few weeks ago now. And that was on the... we were asking for the Court of Session in Scotland to rule on the legality of prorogation. Now, of course, it is a reality. They are seeing it early and they'll see it today.
Yeah.
And those cases hopefully will provide clarity on the legal situation. But this will be solved in only two ways. One is by Parliament taking control, by Parliament not allowing the unelected executive to rule, and making sure the elected Parliament is sovereign in this country. And secondly, by the government realising this is an extremely unpopular move, and that the public will not stomach it. And whilst that will have no legal effect, it will actually have a great effect in making sure that they don't use it in the most aggressive way possible.
Yeah.
And the way that the public can show that is they can attend demonstrations, they can attend a demonstration that's happening this weekend at the Level, or they can go to London, they can sign petitions. And these are important things to show the government that there is a general feeling that it is not the thing to do. And there are other functions that you can do here. Now, I know the government, and some people say that you have to have no deal on the table for us to get a good negotiation.
Yeah.
But this is not how negotiations work. And the best way, analogy that I would use, is that we have driven to the car showroom in our old car, and you have decided to do no deal with the new car that you want to buy. The threat of leaving your old car at the showroom or driving your old car away is no threat at all to the showroom.
Yeah.
In fact, if you're going to leave your old car there, the current deal that we have with the EU, and walk away with no car, you are far poorer off and the showroom's a bit miffed, but they do have a new car.
Yeah. What about a second referendum? Do you think that's coming back into play? Or because that's been quite quiet, hasn't it, over the summer period, which is probably understandable, Parliament hasn't been sitting, but where do you see the second referendum option?
I'm nervous about a second referendum where Boris is Prime Minister and uses all the levers as Prime Minister to spread his propaganda. But it might well be something that we have to seek. I would much prefer to see a caretaker government run for 6 months, run a referendum, and then have a general election. Get Brexit as an issue legally out the way. I don't mean politically it will never be out the way, but legally out the way, so that then we can focus in Parliament on the things that really matter. What we need to do, in my view, is we need to scrap Brexit and rebuild Britain instead, because we can't rebuild Britain if we are in this psychodrama for 10 years. And that's what we will be, because it will be negotiations with the US, negotiations with Europe, negotiations with China, negotiations with Africa, negotiations with Australia. And a lot of these countries we already have trade deals with. We have trade deals with almost all of Africa. We have trade deals with over a third of the Commonwealth. We have trade deals, of course, with Canada. We have trade deals with Europe itself.
Yeah.
At the moment. And so rebuilding just a starting from where we are at the moment is going to take years and years. And that will be a distraction from sorting out our NHS. That will be a distraction from sorting out schools and hospitals.
Yeah. So you would be in favour of revoking Article 15? And if you are, do you think that...
I suspect there needs to be a referendum to revoke it. Not because I like referendum. I think referendum are actually very undemocratic things. This is what Attlee's view was. This is even what Churchill's view was. Because they are used by dictators and totalitarian leaders who control the organs of the media to justify their subversive views. And that's how referendum are used time and time again. And I think that we have a system of democracy in Britain that doesn't use referendum. The only way referendum can be used, if you are a country that has them very regularly. Switzerland voted to ban mosques and minarets. 6 months later, it can change its votes. Switzerland voted to ban freedom of movement. A year later, it can have another referendum to realise the error of its ways. The worst thing of the world, though, is if you're a country like Britain that has referendum rarely and then sees them as binding, because that's not democracy. That ends up destroying all forms of democracy. Because democracy is a dialectic. It is an ongoing process. It is a continuum. And if at any moment you say the people have spoken, it is over, then democracy is over. So I suspect we need to go back to the people and then reconfigure how our democracy works in this country.
Yeah.
And of course, if the people vote to leave, I will still be against it and I will still try and frustrate it, as is permitted under democracy. But it will give a clearer steer to the government of where the people want us to go.
Where do you think we'll be in 2 months' time on the 31st of October?
Well, I have a bet with the director of the Institute of Public Policy Research. And my bet is on the 1st of November we will be in the European Union, and his bet is that we will be out. I hope to be £20 up on the 1st of November.
OK, we'll leave it there. Thanks, Lloyd. Thanks for coming in.
Cheers.